Message from the Galactic Federation of Light for August the 2nd, 2012. One of the tasks that we have come here to help you accomplish is the building of bridges between yourselves, how you see yourselves, how you treat each other, and how you can overcome years of separation through war and economic competition. We have come here as bridge builders to help you overcome what has been for you a great deal of separation, frustration, and even anger and hostility towards one another as you struggled to survive here in a highly competitive environment. One of the reasons why we encourage you so strongly to do what it is you can to better get along with each other throughout your online communities is because your internet is one of the tools that we are utilizing to build these bridges. The people that you are interacting with, no matter where it is in the world they live, are representatives of peoples you may have had difficulties getting along with in the past, not only here on your planet, but in other places throughout this universe as well. When we speak of building bridges, we speak of connecting not only people, but worlds and galaxies, throughout this ever-expansive universe we all share together. What you do today and how you treat each other and get along with each other will have lasting effects for many eons to come, as you are making connections, forging bonds, and creating ties with these representatives from other worlds, some of whom are allies, friends, and who have partnerships in many ventures, though some of those who you are interacting with through your online circles are representatives from worlds that your home worlds may not have a very conducive or amicable partnership with. As some of these worlds have warred with each other and have had long-standing disagreements that have been, up until now, difficult for them to overcome to begin to more peaceably, friendly, cooperatively, and productively work together and strengthen their bonds. When you find yourself in perhaps a weaker moment of frustration and choose to insult another or allow yourself to fall into a tirade with another throughout your online communities, you are doing much more than disrespecting someone, you are disrespecting representatives who are the ambassadors of these other worlds. You are helping to destroy bridges that have been carefully and meticulously built through the efforts of so many for so long. It is as if you are picking up a sledgehammer and driving it into the blocks that have been so perfectly pieced together. Do you understand this? Do you understand what kind of destruction you are doing each and every day when you choose to treat others poorly, disrespectfully, insultingly, meanly, rudely, unkindly, and unforgivingly? We say to you again, all of you, do your best to be on your best behavior. Find a way to be as polite as you can, even if others are showing disrespect for you. We ask you to help us continue to build these beautiful bridges and not help destroy them, for it is these bridges that we will be walking across in friendship and working partnerships with others for many eons of time to come in this universe. Thank you for your cooperation in this matter. When all is said and done, and our mission here on Earth reaches its climax, all of you by that time will have a better understanding of where it is you all come from, your past histories together, and why your work here, which involves how you get along with each other and how you treat each other, is so vitally important, and is the lifeline of this living and breathing universe. Today we would like to begin to speak more in depth about the project to construct seawalls off the coasts of several areas around your planet. Many have asked where it is we will be constructing these protective barriers, and we would like to answer you at this time by saying that we will be building these barriers in many areas, beginning with the state of Florida, in the United States. This is a very suitable place to begin, as this is one area that we feel will certainly receive rising sea levels, as there are geophysical abnormalities off of this coast that will be repaired, in a way, reconstructed, as your planet heals herself from her third dimensional wounds. This is an area where there has been much confusion and mystery throughout your fairly recent history, going back over 100 years or more. It is here in this area that many planes, ships, and lives have been lost in what you have come to refer to as the Bermuda Triangle. It is here in this area that there are great mudslides occurring on the ocean floor, and it is due to these mudslides that so many planes and ships that have gone down have seemingly disappeared. They have not truly disappeared, but in reality they have been buried so, and have been carried away by moving seafloors to other locations, some very far away from where these vessels originally went down. This is one of the reasons why this mystery has survived for so long, as much of the wreckage of these maritime accidents has been washed away. It is these seafloors in this area that are a problem, as deep below them are tectonic plates that are highly unstable in this area. It is these tectonic plates that are one of the larger problems on your planet. These tectonic plates must be repositioned, resolidified, and reattached in some areas to each other. This is a great undertaking, and this undertaking will cause disturbances in and around the waters of this particular area. This is not too hard to imagine, is it, dear ones? It is too hard to imagine that this one area, that many of you know so well, as an area of many accidents, catastrophes, and great mystery, is an area where something is going on. We are at this time explaining to you only one of the things that are going on in this area, as there is something else going on in this area that we shall speak to you about at a later date. As for now, it is beyond the scope of what we are discussing with you today. What we are disclosing with you today is that this area of your planet has what we shall refer to as faulty sea floors, where these floors shift and slide unmercifully at times, causing great disturbances in not only your seabeds, but the surrounding waters as well. When these waters get disturbed so suddenly and so greatly, you can imagine why there are so many ships that have gone down in this area, many without having the time to send a distress signal. These records are well preserved and can be examined by anyone in your world. When one looks at these records, one will find this abnormality, if you will, in maritime accidents in this area, and that many of these crew members of these ships had little or no time to send a distress signal. This should demonstrate fairly clearly that whatever was happening out there in the ocean waters happened suddenly. It was not a storm these ships came upon, but it was something else, and that something else was torrential seas caused by great movements in the ocean floor, which began when the unstable tectonic plates began to shift suddenly and moved a great distance in a relatively short period of time. What we wish to do and we feel is very necessary is to build a reasonably high seawall in this area, giving protection to this area in the case that when repairs begin of these tectonic plates and the ocean floors above them causing a great disturbance in the waters, this water will not pile up and surge towards the unprotected shorelines of this part of your world. Do you understand this, dear ones? Have we been clear on this? This is why we will begin our seawall project with you in this area, as we feel this area will see more evidence of sea surges than any other area. We feel, however, the seawall we will construct with you will be suitable and adequate protection for this area. We feel this explanation will appease at least some of the minds in your world, who currently are firmly rooted in a place of disbelief and distrust about our previous discussions with you on this subject. Please carry on now with your day, keeping in mind, while you interact with others, just who it is they may be, where it is they may come from, and who it is they may represent, as in the end you may be very well surprised to learn just who it is you have befriended, and unfortunately in some cases, you will learn who it is you have been mistreating. As there are many surprises in store for you, dear ones, and learning the true identities of yourselves, of your friends, and all those you have been interacting with throughout your online communities is just one of many wonderful and incredible surprises that await you. We are one of the surprises in store for you, for many of you will be quite surprised to discover just who it is we really are. We are your friends and your families of the Galactic Federation of Light, and we hope you like surprises.